I was going to film the actual installation of my seat, but if I'd done that, it probably would have been 8 hours of me pulling my hair out and getting pissed off. So I've managed to get it in now, so I'm going to do a bit of a retrospective guide to installing the bucket seat in my E46. So these are the tools I use for my bucket seat install. You might not need as much as this, but as normal, I ran into some problems. So we've got some 10mm taps. We've got, I think it's called a pipe wrench for winding the taps in. I've got a 16mm ratchet spanner, a ratchet socket, whatever it's called. I've got a circular metal file, 10mm socket, 16mm socket, and this is the particular scanner I used for resetting the airbag light, which isn't actually supposed to come on, but it did for me. Alright, as per normal, it's raining here. So there it is, installed, just the driver's seat at the moment. So what you want to do first is take it the original seat all the way forward so you can undo the bolts at the back, and wind the seat all the way back so you can undo the nuts at the front. I've got it into quite an upright position to make it easier to take the seat out, and then disconnect the negative from the battery. Then you can lift this or tilt the seat back so you can get to the loom underneath. Disconnect that, then you can take the old seat out. Right, now you have to unbolt the seat belt tensioner from the old seat, or from the old seat frame. I connected that to on basically the other side of what you can see here. So between the new seat bracket and the seat. I took there's a two wire loom that goes with the seatbelt tensioner. You can disconnect that quite easily, and just when you get around to putting the new seat in, then you can just plug it in with just those two wires in the loom. So I bought a Marco Futura bucket seat. It's designed for people between 6'3 and 6'4, because I'm 6'4. So actually that was the main reason for getting this seat, so hopefully I can get a helmet on and start doing some track days. So we've got a nice bit of headroom now. If I can get the zoom right, there we go. So I bought some Cobra brackets. You can see you've got, I think, about four or five vertical ones on both sides, and five the horizontal holes so you can get the seat in the right place. What I found though, they didn't quite match up. These are for E46, but as you can see, I had to use the circular file to file this hole. This was pretty much the only one I had to do. I had to maybe make some of the other holes just a millimetre or two bigger just to get it in the right place, but this one I've had to go about 10mm in this direction so it actually fit. I'm going to get some big solid washers just to reinforce that. That's something I need to do. So the seat came with Allen key bolts and washers. So I mentioned the 10mm taps earlier. For some reason the two rear bolts, they wouldn't bolt back in. They just kept trying to cross thread. Two front ones, because you've got two threads actually stick out of the chassis and you just put a nut on. Don't know why they couldn't do it with all four. Don't know why the two front ones, you need a nut, and the two rear bolts. But anyway, they wouldn't go back in, so I got a 10mm tap and just gently wound it in, loads of grease, get going in and out, just a little bit more at a time, trying to fix the thread. And luckily it did. Now they bolt in all the way down and tighten up. So, yeah, you might need... I think it's fairly, I wouldn't say fairly common, but from Googling it, quite a few people have had issues trying to get the rear bolts back in. The bolts look fine, it's the thread inside the hole. As you can see, even though I'm 6'4", I've actually got the seat and frame as far forward as it will go. I've put the rear one as low as it goes, and the front one, one down from the top one, just because I couldn't physically use the top one. So it slopes backwards, the seat. Try and get that extra bit of headroom then, and just probably make it a bit more comfortable, make the back not so vertical. Alright, so excuse the crappy steering wheel cover I've got at the moment. I want to get a proper one stitched on, but it's actually £4, so I thought I'd give it a go, and it makes it a bit thicker for the time being. So if I'm sitting in the bucket seat now, I'm trying to hold the phone up to my eye line, so that's what I'm seeing now. So I'm a lot lower. So for those people thinking of getting the same seat as me, so I'm 6'4" and 16 stone 3, and I can just, my arse is pretty tight in this seat. In terms of your torso, yeah, it fits really nice, but yeah, your arse is pretty snug in this. But no, it's, I bought it for... seat was 220, and the brackets, the Cobra brackets, I think was 60. So it's pretty good value, really. I will be getting a passenger seat one as well. So the old ones weighed an absolute ton, as you'd imagine. So it'd be quite a good weight saving. It just looks a bit naff with one leather one and one bucket seat. So. Plus, it'd probably get a better weight distribution, and then, you know, if I take some passengers to track days, at least they don't go sliding out their seats. So the only downside of having a bucket seat is getting out of the car, because you look like a right numpty trying to do it. Yeah, that can't be done smooth at all, but it's worth it. So from what I read, you're supposed to disconnect the negative terminal from the battery before you do. Before you actually unplug the seat. That's what I did, but then I still got the airbag light. I'm not really sure why, whether you, some people say you're supposed to leave it for a certain amount of time before you unplug it, but yeah, it's too late for me. So I ended up buying the scanner that you saw at the beginning. Yeah, and that reset the light straight away. So I think it's about £45 on Amazon. So yeah, well worth it. It's earned its cost already, just one use. So with the few mods I've done, the wishbone rear bushes, the HSD Mono Pro coilovers, the bucket seat, and then I had a fast road alignment done and set up and balancing. It's just a different car now. Yeah, it goes around corners like it's on rails. And you don't go flying out your seat anymore. So yeah, definitely recommend it. Just takes your car to a completely different level. So please subscribe. I've got some more mods to come, and I'll be doing some track days in the new year, so I'll be recording them, and they'll be on the channel as well. All right, cheers guys.